عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي المقصرة بتقوى الله، وأحذركم ونفسي من عصيانه ومخالفة أمره لزوما لقوله الحق تبارك وتعالى في كتابه الكريم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وكذلك في قول الحق تبارك وتعالى: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. اتقوا الله، فإن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم، يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت، وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها، وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. My brothers and sisters, if we have any, Alhamdulillah, we are almost half away through the month of Rajab. And as I mentioned in the past, we're still in the series of talking about what we need to be aware of and to get ourselves ready for prior to the month of Ramadan. Because we know that Rajab is one of the Ashhur al-Hurum in which the ulama said that this is the month in which you plant the seed. And Sha'ban, which is the following month, is the month that comes between Rajab and Sha'ban that most people don't pay attention to it. And then here comes the ultimate prize that Allah Azza wa Jal will be giving to certain individuals during the month of Ramadan. And we said that we need to be ready in advance. We need to get ourselves into the training of getting ourselves ready to the level where we're able to engage in Ramadan in a higher level of ibadat, not to start from the zero or the scratch to build up a huge level of ibadat. And we did reflect on the ayat from Surah Al-Isra, in which Allah Jal said, أَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِدُلُوكِ الشَّمْسِ إِلَى غَسَقِ اللَّيْلِ وَقُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ إِنَّ قُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ كَانَ مَشْهُودًا. We talked about the virtue and the value of salah, and how we need to get ourselves ready to be engaged in salah before the month of Ramadan on a level that will allow us to benefit from salah during the month of Ramadan. And then after that, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَا يَزِيدُ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا خَسَارًا. Allah Azza wa Jalla says that He reveals from this Quran what is شفاء وَرَحْمَةً لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَا يَزِيدُ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا خَسَارًا. And in today's khutbah, we will be exploring, as I promised last week, the virtues of Quran, what we need to get from Quran, what is it that we need to train ourselves on prior to the month of Ramadan. We're still having the chance during the month of Rajab to start this training process. Allah Azza wa says in Surah Yunus, كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكًا لِيَدَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكًا يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِظَةٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِظَةٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَشِفَاءٌ وَهُدًى وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً لِقَوْمٍ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِظَةٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. سبحان الله. Beautiful verses explaining to us the essence of the Quran. Ya ayyuhan nas, all mankind, not only the Muslims, all mankind. Ya ayyuhan nas, قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِظَةٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. In the context of tafsir of this ayah, they say that this ayah coincides with the fitrah of the human being. The first thing that Allah Azza wa Jalla addressed the Quran about, what Quran is beneficial for you, is with four things. The first thing is maw'idah. Maw'idah is the advice that you will be getting to keep you aligned between the two lines that would lead you to Allah Azza wa Jal. And that's why the habit of the righteous in the past would be to go to scholars and say, "Idhni." And this is what happened to the khulafa and the in the history of Islam. They would have scholars. They would chase the scholars and say to them, "Idhni, provide for me the guidelines that help me to stay on the right path." Maw'idatan wa shifa'un wa hudan wa rahmatun lil mu'minin. Shifa is what's called a takhliya. Before you start with in reaching and rising and the way you interact with the Quran, you need to cleanse and purify the takhliya. Take all the things that are in the heart that is causing disruption to you in your life, and then replace that with the tahliya, as they say, tahliya qabla tahliya. You need to clean and then to beautify. Before you beautify, you need to clean. And the same is to be said in medically. They take what causes the problem, and then they give what would make the body more rich and powerful. So you need to be guided with the maw'idha from this Quran, and allow this Quran to take all the shubuhat, all the things that would take you away and would cause disruption to you in your relationship with Allah Azza wa Jal, and fill it with hudan. The huda that will be مَنْ يَهْدِهِ اللَّهُ فَهُوَ الْمُهْتَدِ, that will help you to stay on the right path and increase وَزِدْنَاهُمْ هُدَى, increase your connection with Allah Azza wa Jal. وَرَحْمَةً للمؤمنين. When you are benefiting from the maw'idha, the advices, and when you clarify all the things in your heart from that disrupt you from your connection with Allah Azza wa Jal, and fill this with the huda, then you will be complemented with rahmah. Rahmah is what is coming as a result of the previous three things, which is the maw'idha, the shifa, and then the huda. So that you will be from those ruhamau baynahum, as Allah Azza wa Jal described the mu'mineen, the Quran, and you will be like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa ma arsalnaka illa rahmatan lil alamin wa tawasaw bil haqqi wa tawasaw bis sabr. As Allah Azza wa Jal also mentioned in the Quran, wa tawasaw amal salihat tawasaw bil marhama wa tawasaw bis sabr wa tawasaw bil marhama. As Allah Azza wa Jal indicated in the Quran, tawasaw bil sabri wa tawasaw bil marhama, you will be from those who will be encouraging each other to stick and be patient and fulfill the marhama, the rahma, which is something that Allah Azza wa Jal have created and divided to 100 proportion, and send only one proportion among the people in this creation, among all the creation that He created in this universe. And that's why we have rahmah among ourselves. And the 99 rahmah are kept to Allah Azza wa Jal to deal with the mu'mineen in the hereafter. And that's why in the hadith, in another narration of this hadith, that فَلَوْ يَعْلَمُ الْكَافِرُ مَا لِرَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ. If the kafir or the asi would know what Allah Azza wa Jal have kept for himself of the rahmah, he would never give up the tawbah to Allah Azza wa Jal. And vice versa, would make the mu'min all the time alert and afraid from falling into the ma'asi. Allah Azza wa Jal after that says, قُلْ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. قُلْ فَبِنَعْمَةِ اللَّهِ وَفَضْلِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. This Quran, and benefiting from the Quran, and dedicating your time to the Quran, and devoting your life to the Quran, despite of what you think that this is going to take you away from the other things in your life that you're supposed to be busy with in the materialistic attractions of the dunya, Allah is saying to you, قُلْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبْرَحْمَتِي فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. How much are you going to be getting from this dunya compared to those who have left from behind you, and what is have benefited them from what they have accomplished in this dunya? Who have owned this whole earth? Where are they right now? And what has benefited them except the amal al-salih? Look into the Sahaba whom Allah Azza wa Jal have honored them, like Ibn Mas'ud and Ubay ibn Ka'b, whom the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to him once and said, Ya Ubay, Allah Azza wa Jal have asked me to come and read to you Surah Al-Bayyinah. Ubay radiyallahu anhu was overwhelmed and he said, Ya Rasulullah, did he mention to you to do this to all the mu'mineen, or he specifically have mentioned my name to you, Ya Rasulullah? Then he said to him that Allah Azza wa Jal have specifically asked me to read and mention your name so that I can recite Surah Al-Bayyinah to you, Ya Ubay. Ubay was crying as a result of being mentioned by Allah Azza wa Jal in Al-Mala' Al-A'la, as a result of being from those who have taken the Quran, as a result of being grown from those who have dedicated their life to the Quran, not like other people who have done also good in the deen of Allah Azza wa Jalla, like Khalid ibn Walid or even Abu Huraira, who have dedicated themselves into seeking the knowledge and have dedicated themselves to fight in the cause of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Allah Azza wa Jalla have chosen and had given to those who will be dedicating their life to the Quran, the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, a different honor, a different connection, a different level of in their relationship with Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah Azza wa Jal says also in Surah Al-Isra, وَلَئِنْ شِئْنَا لَنَذْهَبَنَّ بِالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ ثُمَّ لَا تَجِدُ بِهِ عَلَيْنَا وَكِيلًا إلا رحمة من ربك إن فضله كان عليك كبيرا قل لئن اجتمعت الإنس والجن على أن يأتوا بمثل هذا القرآن لا يأتون بمثله ولو كان بعضهم لبعض ظهيرا. سبحان الله. This ayah in which Allah Azza says, ولئن شئنا لنذهبن بالذي أوحينا به إليك ثم لا تجد لك علينا وكيلا. This ayah, سبحان الله, when I read it, as if I am reading it for the first time, what Allah is addressing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and saying, "Wala in shi'na," then if we wish, ya Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "lanadhhabanna billadhi awhayna bihi ilayk," then we will be taking what we have revealed unto you, ya Muhammad. "Thumma la tajidu laka alayna wakila," and then you will not find anyone who will intervene and yashfa' laka so that you could have the Quran. And إلا رحمة من ربك, except that the rahma of Allah Azza wa Jal that had made it possible for you to be the man of the Quran, the man whom Allah Azza wa Jal have chosen to be the one who will be delivering the Quran to his ummah, to be the person so that وما أرسلنا من قبلك إلا رجالا نوحي إليهم فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون بالبينات والزبر ونزلنا إليك الكتاب تبيانا لكل شيء ونزلنا عليك الكتاب لتبين للناس ولعلهم يتفكرون. As Allah Azza wa Jalla have assigned this job to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be the person who will be delivering the Quran to the people around him, لعلهم يتفكرون, so that they may reflect and contemplate. The ayat that came from Surah Al-Isra, وَلَئِنْ شِئْنَ لَنَذْهَبَنَّ بِالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ ثُمَّ لَا تَجْدُ لَكَ عَلَيْنَا بِهِ وَكِيلًا, came after Allah Azza wa Jalla said and revealed, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَا يَزِيدُ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا خَسَارًا. سبحان الله. Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying to you, you are my creation, and I know what is best for you. And if you want the best in your life, if you want to be happy, if you want to be content, if you want your life to be in ease despite of the challenges and the difficulties that you might be encountering in your life, then let this be through the Quran. Let be this through the Quran, and do not be from those who are zalimin to the وَلَا يَزِيدُ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا خَسَارًا. Do not be from those who will be losers as a result of not benefiting from the Quran. And in the context of the tafsir of this ayah, وَلَا نَشِئِنَا لَنَذْهَبَنَّ بِالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ, Ibn Mas'ud indicated that يُرْفَعُ الْعِلْمُ, that the knowledge and Islam will be lifting away from the people. And the first thing that will be lifted away from the people is amana. وآخر ما يرفع الصلاة. And the last that will be taken away from this deen is salah. If we were to look into our situation right now as an ummah, we will see that this is unfortunately what is happening into us as an ummah. There is no amana. ضيعت الأمانة. The trust is gone. You rarely will find someone who is trustworthy. You rarely will find someone who is worthy to be trusted in this life. And Ibn Umar indicate that the Quran will be left this dunya and will be taken away back to Allah Azza wa Jal. And when he was told how the Quran will be gone, when we have memorized it in our hearts and when we have taught it to our children, and our children will be teaching it to their own children until the day of judgment. Then he said, and he recited, my brother in the back, could you please be quiet for Salat al-Jum'ah? Then he indicated that he recited this ayah, وَلَا إِنْ شِئْنَا لَنَذْهَبَنَّ بِالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ ثُمَّ لَا تَجْدُ بِهِ عَلَيْنَا وَكِيلًا. He said that the Quran will be lifted from the hearts of the people and will be going back to Allah Azza wa Jal. And لَهُ دَوِيٍ كَدَوِيٍ نَحْل, will be with too much noise. And Allah Azza wa Jal will be asking the Quran, and he knows best what is matter with you. He said, Ya Allah, and listen to this, Ya Allah, I have left the people because they only read me and do not apply me in their life. This is the huge crisis. This is the most troubling problem that we have nowadays in our life, that the Quran had become a cosmetic issue in our life. We listen to the Quran to soothe our ears so that we could be in comfort. We have neglected the fact that this Quran is something that Allah Azza wa Jal had revealed to us so that we can benefit from, so that we are able to change our life, so that this Quran will be a rahmah, so it will be a shifa, so that it would be hudan, so it would bring to us the change in our life. This is what we need to be mindful about. Benefit from the Quran. Benefit from the Quran before it is too late, and the Quran will not be available to us to benefit from anymore. This is what this ayah is saying. وَلَئِنْ شِئْنَا لَنَذْهَبَنَّ مِنَ الَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً مِنَّا. Allah Azza wa Jal is saying that it's only the rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jal that would make it possible for you to be able to enjoy and benefit from this Quran. This is a gift from Allah Azza wa Jal had given to us. So let us in the coming days before the month of Ramadan, let us be from those who will change their connection with the Quran, who will change the way we interact with the Quran. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. Allah Azza wa Jal is saying, shall they not contemplate and reflect upon the Quran? Because this is what is the whole idea of reading the Quran. Ibn al-Qayyim, rahmatullahi alayhi, indicate that there is something special in the Quran. And there are ayat that would have a shifa for your heart. If you, when you are reading the Quran, feel that this is an ayah that have captured your attention, this is an ayah you feel that you have a connection with, do not pass it, but rather read it over and over and over again. Even as he indicates, if you were to spend the whole night reading this only one ayah from the Quran. Because in this ayah is what you have shifa for what is in your heart. And he referred that this ayah will be the thing that will clarify the things in your heart. Look into the example of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu said that he stood up between the hands of Allah Azza wa Jal for the night prayer and spent the whole night praying and contemplating and reflecting on one ayah. إِنْتُ تُعَذِّبْهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادَكَ وَإِنْ تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. And in the following morning, Abu Dharr رضي الله عنه said, Ya Rasulullah,
You spend the whole night doing nothing but repeating this ayah. Why is that, Ya Rasulullah? He said that I have prayed to Allah Azza wa Jal throughout the night and asked Him to give me the shafa'ah. And as a result, Allah Azza wa Jal had given me to the shafa'ah to those who are seeking the shafa'ah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar. This is what the Quran is all about. It's about opening the gates of rahmat for you. It's about opening the secrets. It's about giving you those bonuses. Maybe one night of reflection or one moment of reflection when you're reading the Quran. Doesn't necessarily have to be in the salah, but it could be any time. There is nothing to prevent you from reading the Quran, even if the sister were to be having the time of the month where she's not praying, she's still allowed to read the Quran. Even if you do not have the state, and you are not in the state of wudu, though that the ulama indicate that it's best to have the state of wudu to read the Quran. Even that, do not prevent yourself and deprive yourself from the barakah of reflecting and reading on the Quran. You never know. Maybe this ayah, maybe this recitation, maybe this reading of the Quran will be the one that will, insha'Allah, open the rahmat onto you that will be beneficial for you in the dunya and the deen and the akhirah. وَأَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ فَأَفَوْزَ الْمُسْتَغْفِرِينَ. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك اللهم على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم إن عبيدك أبناء عبيدك أبناء إمائك نواصين يا رب بيدك ماض فينا حكمك يا رب عدل فينا قضاؤك يا رب. نسألك اللهم بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك أنزلته في كتابك أو علمته أحدا من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك بأن تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا يا رب. اجعله جلاء لهمومنا وأحزاننا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تبارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وتبلغنا اللهم من رحمتك ومنك وجودك وفضلك وكرمك علينا شهر رمضان وتجعلنا فيه من عتقائك من النار. اللهم أعنا على الصيام، اللهم أعنا على القيام، اللهم أعنا على قراءة القرآن، اللهم اجعلنا ممن يتدبرون القرآن، اللهم اجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. ربي أوزعنا أشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علي وعلى والدي وأن أعمل صالحا ترضاه وأصلح لي في ذريتي إني تبت إليك وإنني من المسلمين. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وأقم الصلاة.